fucking around. I'm typing. I'm not listening. I'm always typing.
Oh, really? I see.
I'm typing the heading. Like, am I not supposed to type the heading? Anyway. Let's go. Okay, hello everybody. How are we doing today? I didn't want Champions League to distract me. So, real quick, if you want to follow my story all day, I'm going to talk about, see, 30 years ago. Things we Nkrumah don't analyze, Fela don't analyze, and I'm not gonna even mention myself among the greats, but even things we Mi'kmaq don't talk about 5-10 years ago, suddenly, at the time, everybody they say, oh no, acting like they don't know, like they don't hear, but suddenly now, your politicians are repeating the same thing. It's true. Like when we are talking here, and then they'll go for. When CNN say the same thing, that's when you believe it. Or when one white man says the same thing. There's a new book where they just write what Britain did to Nigeria. And I see some top intelligent academicians and our intelligentsy are fawning over this book, falling over themselves, acting as if the things where this guy they talk for this book is new information. And that's one of the great tricks where our elites they use for this our society. You know, when their masters don't talk something, they'll come, they act like they never hear them before. Like, they don't know, wow, this is. Whereas we have been saying that thing for 15 years, for 20 years. Nobody listen. Nobody act like it's facts. So, why is it that anytime we Africans come up with information, come up with independent research, come up with analysis of our situation, why be say Nigerian? Intelligentsia, that is the academic community, they tap into those information and they carry them ahead, they follow through with such investigation or analysis. Why we say many of the theories we don't come up with to solve the issues of Nigeria and African people at large, the Nigerian professional academic where the ideas are supposed to come from negate these things and don't follow through. Before I even tell you the reason why, I'll give you a big example. Because right now in Nigeria, almost all professional guilds are on strike. You understand? Right now for Nigeria, almost every professional guild or association of professionals are on some kind of strike. Resident doctors, lawyers, judges and court staff, National Assembly staff, ASU strike, everybody, every teachers, everywhere you look, left, right, center, everybody is on strike. Check it. Is either they are striking or they are giving notice that they are going to strike. Almost all sector under federal government control, under our national control, not the private sector. You know, say private sector for Nigeria. No matter what they happen for Nigeria, all these ones, somebody they collect salary, everything is fine. Private sector, no one knows whether anything they happen. Thousands of children might be dying every day. That's the reason for them to even work harder the next day. Because there's not new job opening that they can put their own people. So they don't want to hear that one. The whole country can be growing up in flames. Bankers will still go to work tomorrow morning. Nothing like we are striking in solidarity with the suffering of our people. That will not be happen. So if you look all of them right now with the strike, go and look at their demands. None of their demands, they people oriented. All their demands, now for their allowance, personal, their income, their privileges that are being denied. That's not the only thing. See, the resident doctors, when I see their list of demand for the strike, I weep for this country. I wept. It was all about their COVID allowance. You see, make some of them give Nigerian doctors this information. Tell Nigerian doctors, say I say, if to say they don't begin strike when they don't give their patients injection, if they don't they strike, say because they don't put their patients for good hospital bed, say no medicine to treat Nigerian people. If they were striking when the healthcare industry, the health ministry, begin to shortchange the people of this country in their healthcare. You know, instead of giving us everything, they begin to defund healthcare for this country. The doctors kept quiet because they get private option. They get option to escape. So now, the more the option dwindles, the more the option dwindles. Now they remember they want to strike. But if doctor real work not to help people to survive, to help people to live, your first strike must come when you no longer have that ability to heal people. When people are hungry, they hold your healing hands behind your back. Nobody strike then. Instead, everybody will run, go open their own private hospital. Go look at the judges when they strike. Costa said that they strike. They want judicial independence. They don't strike. So they want to make judiciary for Nigeria. They actually deliver justice. How many people are in awaiting trial because of this is what's going on in this country. This is what is going on in this country, left, right, and center. Because there's an anti-Africanness in the foundation of academia. In the foundation of academia, whether you go learn for Switzerland or you learn for Kafanchan, the same anti-Africanness runs through the entire educational system in this world. So there's no way, the more you educate yourself in this their way, the more you are trapped in anti-African behavior. So now, why are African professional academicians, that is the intelligentsia, the people that are supposed to be the thinkers, why is it that their brain are so against African people? Why? I realize. Now, because there's nothing African about what they do. I repeat, now because there's nothing African about what they do. If African people embrace their Africanness, if we begin to remodel society according to our African values, many of these so-called professionals will no longer exist. They will no longer exist because Africa, we have socialized all professions except those professions where we say you need deep knowledge, where we say you need serious training, the real knowledge. Now those ones, nine videolities, when they socialize for Africa. So you see, I can understand why the best lawyer in the world, the best lawyer in Nigeria, is not fighting for Nigeria. Because without Oyibo for Africa, there will be no such thing as a lawyer. Who be lawyer for Africa? Everybody for Africa now be lawyer. For African law, you cannot cheat anybody. Everybody know the law. The law is straightforward. Because African law is a law of justice. European law is a law of intimidation. There are two different things. European law is in such a way we say, if you are existing in Europe or America, in Nigeria like this, if you are alive as a human being today, under European law, European system of law is just like religious law. you must always be committing a crime. Nobody in this world, even the best human being, if you read all the legal code, you must commit crime. There must be overlook harmony. If governments of this world decide to prosecute every crime waiting for their law books, everybody might be in jail. If you go for England, go some outdated laws from 1656 there for their books. Do you understand? For Africa, our own law, everybody know her. Nobody be lawyer. You can't lawyer anybody. No such thing as architect. Everybody then they build their own house. So all these professional jobs where Europeans bring through exclusion, because you know when you study hard to understand enough, you're gonna say European educational system is a system where they say they want to exclude as many as possible, not to accept as many as possible. You understand? So you know if you just say you be architect, they'll say well, your license. And that license means you have to go through their own thinking of becoming an architect. Yes. But Africa, every man building no house. So no chance for architect. You understand? Who be doctor? Everybody know you, everybody know they live. Except the real sickness in Jinle. Hey, maybe if you go meet Babalawo. Hey. Well, you see all these jobs. Who be banker? Bank waiting. How can you even accumulate enough to have bank? Want to help people keep their money. Help me keep my money. Why? Because somebody who is stealing my money. In Africa, our market, nobody did there. It's open market. Nobody go there. You go take what you want, you go pay, you go. So you see, all these our professionals in Africa. I don't tell you this thing before for one of our home sessions, but now is the best eye view. We discuss, I must say, the first lawyer, civil servant for Africa. Now, Oyibo trainer, not the African person trainer. And that Oyibo trainer with hate, the Oyibo hate him because na racist, na imperialist. He treat him like monkey, treat him like animal. The first lawyer, the first doctor, the first whatever. They went through their white pastors. We teach them with hate, anger, oppression, disdain. You understand? Treat them, you know, like somebody would teach a monkey. Treat them like somebody would treat a dog. You understand? But at the same time, telling them, say, that thing what they teach them is making them more special than every other African. So whatever insult, whatever thing they are receiving, whatever dehumanizing behavior that Oyibo is behaving, is appropriate. It's appropriate because they are making you better than all other Africans by learning this thing, by getting this their degree, that you can use to apply for this their license, for you to operate in this their world. So this our forefathers, then when they put this Mugu men, they carry this their Mugu behavior. Conscience is the real way to behave to people be that. So all these men, they think say the only way to train a country to teach, is to treat us like animals, the way they were treated like animals. Because they tell them say their African culture is stupid. So that their law degree make them more special than any African we don't live before. You understand what I'm saying? Now that mentality all of them carry. We say me go and carry, and if you know how you go school for this country or any country in the world as a black person, where you know go become anti-African inside your brain. The kind of things they tell us about ourselves. It isn't a joke, so they tell us, say, now white human can't stop the cleaning of twins for Calabar. First of all, imagine how small Calabar is in the grand scheme of what Africa represents to us as Nigerian people, to us as African people waiting for this area. Calabar is so tiny. But yet, they see him as necessary to teach everybody in this country. Say, we they kill small children, and now Oyibo can't save them. They don't tell us why Calabar people begin kill twins in the first place. Calabar people, before the coming of Europeans, their major deity, what did they worship, in form a twin. Like yin and yang was two people, when two people are born, that was the balance of humanity. So Calabar people used to worship twins. Then when Christians come, teach them the way that they teach us in layman, say everything that is not Jesus Christ is the devil. If you don't worship God, anything you worship is the devil. And the twins of all represented that the so how can I put that? Oh, these two they worship now devil. Twins are evil. Now the same Christians will make them begin, they kill the twins. Now after a long drop, one day say, it's okay. And they come and teach us that in our schools. They come and teach us that in our schools. Nobody teach us about any great thing we our ancestors do. Look at us. Look at our brain inside our school. We go to school 12 years in a classroom in Nigeria. Nobody tell you how to stop, how to behave for police checkpoint. What kind of education as a Nigerian? If truly this education is not anti-African, how can you go to school in Nigeria and they don't teach you how to behave in police checkpoint? When we know police checkpoint is police checkpoint is almost like culture for Nigerian people. You must experience. They're not going to tell you about injustice. They're not going to tell you about oppression. So, this anti-African behavior, now make it easy for those who don't love African people to continue to use our professionals against us. Because once this professionals and their anti-African senses are told again, now this is 500 years later, after all the things we don't see with our own two naked eyes for this world as African people, when they come now, they can't tell these same people, say, I beg, this business contract I'm giving you is I'm giving you because you are the best African, you are special, you are educated. They'll take that thing, damage their own people again, say, is African people's progress. Yeah, we are making progress. Progress for who? Progress for who? Nestle company. Nestle, this big company. Nestle is in one town near Abuja, depriving the villagers of water to drink in our own African people, Oyiboko. So the children of people now have to leave their community because they've given the river to Nestle. The local community that have been living there for hundreds of years can no longer access their river. They have to cross the express. Do you know how many of their children are dying now because they have to cross the express to drink water? But now one Nigerian academic could not draw up all those plans, could not approve them, could not approve them inside the office, say that is the right thing to do in Africa. That is the right thing to do in Africa. Because I won't know how all these bad things they happen for this country. All these nonsense things will happen left and right. Now our professionals they sign them, black men like you and I. Why? Because our educational system is so anti-African that it makes it okay to destroy African communities, African environment, and tarnish African culture. Only Africans will do this kind of thing in the world and get away with it. African gun will support you to do it. If she won't talk against you, they will say she won't hate her. I won't go make t-shirts. Hate her. Now my new t-shirt for 2021 be that. I won't go make new t-shirt. Hate her. Now I will put for the shirt. So make another say somebody they ashamed of this on a tag. When they say hater, when somebody tell you the truth of a fucked up behavior, when you carry degree for hand, say you get brain, I get sense. They follow politicians through the up and down. They spoil Nigeria say, because now your friend, they live large. Before you talk one thing, two things now, they go say, we are tired. We are tired. This country don't tire me. You were tired, you go still turn up this night. What are you really? Are you tired or are you turning up? Which is it? You can't do the two at once. Every time we are tired. Tired of what? You are still turning up. People with the tired never be turn up. When you are tired, you are not turning up. Now energy person they turn up. Person don't tire, no they turn up. I'm tired for this country. I'm tired. 10 o'clock, 11, everybody don't turn up. Abi? People are not tired, they are just broke. That's all. When you have money in your pocket, you remember that you are tired. Nobody's tired in Nigeria. When we are tired, everything's going to change. Because we won't have energy for nonsense. We only have energy to do what we believe is going to move this country. The country, the first. This is another thing that kills me in Nigeria. How we believe that turning up is the solution to frustration. How do you believe that, okay, if our country they scatter, our country they spoil, they go. We don't frustrate. We don't vex. We don't get hope again. The answer is to go and drink. Is to go and party. That's the answer to your frustration. You know, you say they don't. I say we don't craze. No other answer. They don't put up so many false gods on TV. We don't captivate our mind as black people. From our black misleadership for America to our African misleadership for Nigeria, they don't bamboozle us with lies and false images so long that we by ourselves no fit think correctly. We always apply the opposite. We apply problem for solution. Instead of applying solution to a problem, we apply problem put for solution. I'm telling you, that's what I see in this country. Because I'm all for having a good time, but not all the time. We really need help. We really need help in terms of, you know, how we the response we will give to oppression for this country. Our response to our situation must improve. You know, our response must improve. You know, I don't care is not the answer to not being cared for. We as a, you know, people, you have to imagine your government as your as the father and mother of everybody. So now this our father and mother say they don't care about us. We don't care about ourselves. We don't go enter street, go us, not be so we're supposed to do. Abi. So now bring them in the level of say public service, public servant. No one help the public. Then instead of me, the public enter streets to make the public servants doing job, work well, make sure everything right. We say, hey, you don't care. We go on the people where they show, say, you don't care. We go show yourself, say, we don't care about ourselves. Pass you. Which kind of answer be that? Well, because they talk about TV, say it's appropriate. Is it now correct answer be that? Say, you only live once. Live your life. Enjoy yourself. Let me tell you something. I know life is short, though. Life is short because, you know, I can't even believe I'm 38. I closed my eyes yesterday to be Nana. I'm 38. But, bro, life is also long, fam. Life is also long. All these things they do, by the time you go jump quota, you'll be too late. You now have serious 30 years of serious suffering in front of you, eh? You know that suffering where they look now, say, other people, they suffer. You say, that's how they start. Many of them who grew up for poor home, grew up in poor homes, became teenagers, young boys, enter street, meet link, begin to do some little things, thinking, yeah, I'm on the way, go, God, back to square one. Not be me talking, you can Google this fact. The World Bank themselves, World Bank themselves, World Bank says you have a higher chance of winning the lottery than dying above the class you are born in. Let me repeat. World Bank say you have a higher chance of winning the lottery than dying above the class you are born in. So it's not how you live, bro, it's how you die. It's not how you live. You might live rich and die broke. Amoye. Amoye. That's why I know. See, it is the anti-Africanness of the Nigeria African intelligentsia, which include our politicians. Now I'm gonna make them think say that they live large as they do now. Because all our commonwealth that they monetize, suppose they use them for legacy projects to develop the country so that their children in future can live the life that they are living now. But their stupid children, because of their own anti-Africanness also, not understand, say, that rabat when they rabat with their papa, they enjoy private jet, they go party, they chop money, they live life. It is their future, their attitude, they are following their parents to eat now. I'm not joking. I mean, first them Enrico Tiebo, where is his family today and all the money this man had? Do you know who Enrico Tiebo was in Nigeria? You know who be that? You know who Enrico Tiebo be for this country? What and what did he get today? Where is it? Abiola Nko, name one Abiola company that is still functioning in this country today. Name one Abiola company that is still functioning. I'll give you $1,000. Name one. People think that this thing, see, we must purge ourselves of this anti-African. Then they make us fear. We are afraid of ourselves. We fear ourselves. Because if we are afraid of anything African, we are afraid of ourselves. And we must remove that fear. We must remove that fear so that we can face what we need to face. We can face what we need to face in this country. Not be about this motherfucking different lies that they give us through their stooges. You understand what I'm saying? Be careful, man. Be careful. Our future is at stake. All these people, them own all the TV, own all the radio, own every goddamn shit. They give you the information that they want you to operate. They want us to the level where they want me to operate on, that the information that they give you be that. It is our own duty to operate in a higher level, to vibrate higher than they expect. Because if we don't vibrate higher than they expect, then we are playing to their hand. They can predict us. That's where they predict us for answers. Because nobody they hear when they're telling them for answers, and they talk, nobody they hear. See now, where are we? How many people still telling about her? Who is still talking about it? Who is involved? Now, make sure they just myself that they do MOP. Who is involved anymore? They don't hand now over to inquiry. Inquiry, okay. If you go hear Fela song or no soldier when they burn our house, 1,000 soldiers come our house, oh ha, broad daylight, afternoon, not be night, burn the house down, kill people, do anyhow. Waiting inquiry talk. Unknown soldier. Now they don't tell you now unknown order. Listen, fella talk for unknown soldier, the song. He say, fella say, government bring instruments of magic, then bring inquiry. Instrument of magic. The first thing where they bring is inquiry. That's the first thing. So our intelligentsia, they must always deceive us. Go read through, you know, if you go university, social sciences, economics, anthropology, sociology, all the philosophy, go and listen to their masters talking. Those people that form the theories of these great sciences that we study in universities. Go and listen to them. They were all racists, all haters of the black flesh. One thing about African people, whom I respect, no matter how undignified our existence is today. No matter how dehumanized we are today as African people, one thing where they like to say, we will never allow those at the top to spread hate deliberately. Hateful ideas in Africa are not mainstream, never can be mainstream. You must go out of your way to find your hate in Africa. And even though you don't find out, even though people are strong, you cannot come for everybody, they just call you, yeah, your head, talk anyhow. Africans don't allow that. Trump, if to say Trump, na African man, he can never win election. Trump cannot, you see, after he don't win, if he win, all this, idea. But to say Trump, they for this Nigeria, they talk, say, kill this one, throw this one out, I will lock everybody up. He can never win election here. Africans will never support you if you come out like that. You must first lie to us, deceive us where we're. You must first lie, deceive us where we're. Then when you can't enter, can't change. Hey. But say you just come out of the back with some hateful rhetoric, Africans are not following you anywhere. You might get your followers, don't get me wrong, you will have followers, oh, don't get me wrong, but you never get to the power. You will never get to that power. You have your followers, but say in election like this, say Nigeria won't follow you, never. Never. You know, you can't be a Trump, you can't be a Boris Johnson and rule in Africa. Never. No, they do like that. You go first lie. You must lie and say you nice. You go lie, say you good. When you don't call lie, you can't enter, you can't change. That one we like. But you go and look at the history of white intelligentsia, of white academia. Go and look at the history of eugenics, which was the science that they based their racism on. You understand? They based their racism on this science, eugenics. Racism come from the top of European society, man. Fascism, look at an idea like fascism, man. An idea where this Queen of England embraced, man. You see, the Queen of England father was a fascist sympathizer. Hitler supporter, openly supporting Hitler, even though his country was fighting a war against Germany. Openly supporting them. You understand what they tell you? Now, fast forward some 60, 70 years later. One woman will say she get black for her. We say she get black inside her, can't go marry into that kind of family. Say, the thing say she be racist. They can't behave racist to her. She dey mad. All of us grew up with the story of Pocahontas. Because one girl tell me, say, hey, love the guy. I say, love is not enough. Now, I'll tell you this. Let me give you the story of Pocahontas. All of us, we grew up, we watched that year Disney cartoon. We all read the story of Pocahontas. This native Indian girl. Where in people, they in at war with English people before they become Americans. They were being on the process of becoming Americans. Stealing her people's land and fighting war with her people. Then she now fell in love with one of the soldiers of this people, now went behind the people's back to give these soldiers the secret of how to invade the people's land. And white people support that girl till tomorrow. Pocahontas, all of us know her name. I don't forget her traditional name. Say she go for Wapa or something. She get traditional name. A true Indian name before Oyibo give her a racist name, Pocahontas. You know, they love her. You know, imagine. They can't give her a pet name, Pocahontas. White people are wicked. I'm telling you. You know, remove her only name because they call her pet name. You know. So imagine, this girl betrayed her people because she was in love with a white man. And they sell that story to us like it is an okay story. Because they know, say, if our women buy into that false notion of love, then they can easily defeat our people and our races. Look at us today. So because you dare in love with one guy, you feel the love when you get for that guy, your personal feeling with that guy, they make you feel, is enough for you to betray the entirety of your own people. And they praise such, and they tell us, they make us to think that that is a noble thing to do. So that's why when we too, we see opportunities, even we as men, we're supposed to be the defenders of our people. When we see opportunities to betray the majority of our people for our own personal enrichment, even we, you know, we accept. And we only accept because of our anti-Africanness in our brain. They don't really key us down. They don't really key us down not to love ourselves, not to love Africa, not to respect. Not to respect Africa. We don't respect our culture. That's why you go see, even our movies are anti-African movies, man. Our movies, they show it on TV. Insulting our gods, insulting our religious system, making a mockery of our religious system. Go on Instagram every day, everybody making a mockery of our religious system. Now everybody is saying, cut me soap. They've reduced African spirituality. Oh, Africa, cut me soap. Anyway, anybody will cut you soap, ask for incantation. No? There's no soap without incantation. Just remember that one. So now we are willing to embrace a mockery, you know, cut me soap. But how about embracing it in actuality? Why? So yeah, if you are an African professional on this life today, if you get the intelligence here, the people with DM, the DM, me, ma, myself, trust me, in Nigeria, I grew up, and I tell people, say, even though I be Fela Pikin, where I grew up with Abamieda, Elenio, my father, I saw him every day. I was anti-African as hell. I was anti-African as fuck. Because all to my papa they tell me, now only my papa they tell me. Nothing to validate it in society. I'm telling you, not what you learn in the house. You need validation from your own peers. When my mate only talk, my teacher only talk, they only talk for TV, they only talk for anything. Only my papa they talk, I mean, papa, yeah, calm down. I had to grow up. But because I had a father like that, and that information don't really leave my mind. So when I see the information again, growing up as a child, as an into a man, now I was 23, 24. My father don't die since I be 14. People, they always forget that one. Fella died, I was 14. I was barely a teenager when my father died. You know? I was not 23, 24. I begin to see those information again. And I recognize the information. Okay, let me start diving deep. My own journey starts. So yes, being my father's son allowed me to recognize the information when I see him. You understand? But not be waiting, open my eye with that. Our programming, the indoctrination into anti-Africanness. You need to study many of these great men. Where people, I mean, all European kings were racist. All their scientists were racist. They all believed that they are superior to everybody. Trust me on this. So they put them into the foundation of their educational system. The knowledge, you understand? The method of learning. So you go to university, they get what they call recommended reading material. All of them will go to school, know that one. Now that recommended reading material, they kill you for it because it's so big. Then the alternate thing is if they'll give you other ones, but the amount of books that you have to read in line to pass. By the time you read those ones, you don't have time to read the other books that counter those arguments. You don't have time to read any other thing to counter them. They give you recommended reading material. Then they say, well, there are other books you can read about this topic too, written by this person. Sometimes they don't even tell you at all. Even in our music, I studied music. The terminologies they use for our music is racist, folk music, traditional music. What is the meaning of that? that their own music be professional music, classical music. Those terminologies are racist. You don't understand? It makes, because they'll explain our own art like it is monkey that did it. Whereas now our own art, the whole world they dance to today. How many people they dance to Mozart? Who they dance to Beethoven today? Go go and see play African music from 500 years ago. Maybe they bring conga here with talking drama, but I got dale. Everybody go begin dance. Even our music from 1,000 years ago is still making people dance. It's still making people transcend themselves. I love your talk, but the smoking aspect of it puts me off. Hey, log off now. Yeah? See me see trouble. So, God, log off, Jerry. It's not my lungs. Not your lungs. Listen. Our music, even the way they teach me music, make me feel as if my music is less than their music. So I understand that there's no way they'll not teach you that in medicine. As if their pills is better than our herbs. And we all believe that. We all believe all the things. And it's all steeped in anti-Africanness. It's all steeped in anti-Africanness. And my favorite poet in the world, his name is Saul Williams. Luckily for me, me and Saul, we share the same manager. That's one of the things that make me happy about my management. That my manager and Saul Williams' manager is the same guy. Because Saul is, hands down, my favorite poet alive today. And Saul says something that really sticks with me all the time. Saul says, black people are not free. We are just loose. I repeat, black people are not free. We are just loose. You know, like you take your pet to the park, you know, and then you leave him on his leash to run around loose. He's not free, but when it's time, you drag him back. When you are ready, you kill him. But when you brave like a mad person. So I realized, because you see, freedom is hard. They want you to feel like freedom is easy. People think freedom is the ability to do as you like. But that's a lie. That means you are just loose. You have no self-control. You have no restraint. You don't know how to pace yourself. You understand what I'm saying to you right now? When they tell you freedom is the right to do anything you like, tell that person to shut the fuck up. Freedom is the ability to do the things that are hard. I repeat, freedom is the right and ability. Ability is good, but most especially, freedom is the right to do the things that are hard. If you live your life doing the things that come easy to you, you are loose, not free. You are only loose, you are not free. It is when you can do those things that are hard. When you can stand where everybody is saying yes and say no. When you can turn your back on a good time today so you can have a better time tomorrow. That is what it means to be free. But we all run around doing the things that are easy. And we say we are free. You are free to get drunk. You are free to insult your elders. Free to misbehave. Free to be criminals. Free to lie. Free to cheat. Free to be disloyal. Free to be untrustworthy. Right? But are you free to have good education? Are you free to have good health care? Are you free to have good housing? Are you free to see anywhere you want to see in this world? As an African man, can you wake up today and say, oh, I want to go and see Switzerland. I want to move around in this world. Are you free to move? Are you free to move? Say you are free. Europeans can move anywhere they fucking want to go in this world. Just wake up in the morning. Even our country now, they say now visa on arrival. Can you do visa on arrival to UK? We are not free, we are just loose. And until we decide to be free, and to be free is to do the hard things, man. Not to cheat, not to oppress and exploit. That's easy. To exploit powerless people. To exploit unarmed people. Disorganized, weak people. Is that freedom? The person that is buying private jet of $30 million, is he free to use the $30 million to build a hospital for his people, or is he in the cage of capitalism? Is he free enough to spend that money in any other way? This is what I ask. Look at how all our elites spend money in this country. There is something to it. Everybody cannot be thinking the same way now. Don't let us sit down and say, all of us will just be doing the same thing, you know, buy house, build car, buy plane, be a helicopter, chase women, just be doing the same thing. None of us is going to be different. All of us, same thing. Hey! See me see trouble. How are these people all doing the same things if they are free? If they are truly free, there will be some variety in their behavior. A few of them will be like that. A few of them will be the way I'm talking to them. A few will even be other way, but it's a lie. You can understand that these people are in a cage. They're in a prison. They're in the prison of profit. In the prison of capital. They cannot think any other way. It's a prison. They are not free to be. They cannot really be. They can't be. To truly be free, one must begin to exercise the freedom muscle. And in Africa, that muscle is weak, it's sad, it's flabby. That muscle is flabby. You need to work on that muscle to get it strong. Because this is when we know that we are doing the right thing. As my friend Victor will say, mold your clay, bruv. Mold your...
Bandits here, baby. That's a good gene. Before bandits obtain you.
So please, it is harder to tell the truth than tell a lie in this country. But it is only the truth that can save us in this country. It is harder to be honest than to be dishonest in this country. But you have to be, you have to, all of you say we'll be hard, man, hard, we'll be hard, we hard. You understand? But why are we only hard to do easy things? Hard men to do soft things. Why? Hard men must do hard things. To fuck girls is not hard. We must have the life for ourselves. To fuck plenty women is not hard. Why are we deceiving ourselves? To go and smack around defenseless people, that's not hard. To go and burn down defenseless communities, that's not hard. To be rude to our elders, is that hard? Rude to your parents, that's what it means to be hard. No, man. That's soft. That's pussy shit. That's baby pussy behavior, immature behavior. Youngin. You are a youngin, fam. That's youngin. Now we grow up into matured men. What are we doing as hard matured men? We hard men. What are we doing? So, ladies and gentlemen, I know that I don't deviate from the topic small, but everything join. Everything join themselves. Everything join. It's difficult. Everything join themselves. You know? So anyway, congratulations to all Chelsea fans on your 1-1 today. You know, very soon, so we'll praise ourselves when stationary stores, you know, go stores, that's my club in Nigeria. If you don't know this club I support in Nigeria, Stationery Stores. That's my club. So yeah, I am very happy that you guys are 1-1 with Real Madrid. So that's tonight's bird eye view. Let's try and express freedom by doing the things that are hard. Yeah.